It's Thursday night. Hippio shits, everyone. It's internet famous Joe Martin. And it's Thursday, 7 o'clock Eastern Standard Time. Have ourselves a little drink. How the hell are you? I hope the answer is well. I hope you all are doing well. I wasn't sure if I was going to do this. I'm kind of tired. And I realized we started something big, and we need to continue playing that something big. That game, of course, is Final Fantasy III. We're going to be getting through one of at least two, maybe three. Maybe we'll get through all three of them. Maybe we'll make some decent progress on it. I think I'm kind of low level from a save. But we're not interested in that right now. We are interested on... top of the hour talk. Let's talk about Taco Bell. Taco Bell meal today was two chicken enchilada burritos. I used a reward point thing from the cravings menu and got myself a cheesy bean and rice burrito. And the glass of the nectar, the old Mountain Dew large total meal came under $9. Pretty shocked, pretty filling. I did not eat the other chicken enchilada burrito, but overall, I'd still say it's about a B average meal. I have been requested to put together or make some kind of Taco Bell enthusiasm merch for Thursday Night Retro Game Night. I know it is a favorite of some of y'all to talk about the Taco Bell, and... I'll have to figure out some kind of clever slogan or something that I can do where the good folks at Taco Bell will not sue me for doing so. But that's neither here nor there right now. That's the Taco Bell talk of the hour. Moving forward, what do we got? What do we got? We are playing games. That's what we do on this channel. Look at that. Final Fantasy III. We're going to pick up from the old save file. Hopefully not going to overwrite the save file because that would be embarrassing. Look where we are. We're at this lovely part. Controller's map, thank God. No dialogue yet. Let's check. I'll make sure my audio is fine. I didn't really test it. Yeah, so here we are. We've made it to here. There's Mog. He's level 15. He's higher level than everybody. And we get to choose who to start off with. We got this one, which is pretty much the objectively easiest. Then to this, and then this guy right here is the long one. So I'll wait a minute if you guys are watching. Let's check the old users in chat. I don't think any of you are actually watching, which is fine. So I'm talking to myself. Let's start with the Terrabanan Edgar. I don't hear anything. I don't think you're supposed to. Okay, yeah, it's come through the audio here. Couple more fights. Again, the easier of them. Last week was crazy. I didn't get a chance to play. We had something going on. I think I was just tired. It was just a hell of a week. So I'm glad to be back here on Thursday Night Retro Game Night. Let's level some old heroes here. Oh, I hate this part. Most of this game feels like it's splitting the party. Oof. Heal, cause I gotta. What he's good at. Day is at work right now. We'll be home soon, probably during the stream. We'll see how long I can play. I kind of want to hang out with my wife. I haven't really been able to hang out too much lately. That should be it for this part. So we just gotta walk to Nersh. And I don't even think it's that far. Oh my god. So we gotta take a secret path that we remember from earlier. Immediate fight. Again, we're playing the classic Super Nintendo version of this. I could have opted for the GBA version. I kind of like to have the option of all of the weird little buggies and stuff. Because there's some fun stuff that you can find much later. The Pixel Remasters, of course, have the options to get triple XP and level a lot faster, so you don't have to do as much of the grind. But they also remove a lot of the glitches and accidental problems that this game had. So. Doing there. Can't go in there. Come on, go around. Can't go that way. Problems there. Hang out with the Moogles in their little cave. Oof. The Mog will not join you yet. Gotta come back for him. Nothing of consequence. I fought all this stuff already. It would. Do you have a Taco Bell near you, Easy? I don't know how the sort of north but still south works with your Taco Bell and your location. Only bears. Well, a good trade-off, I guess. Always something to do. Avoid being mauled by nature. That's something. Oh, shit. I'm very early on. Really? That's pretty cool. Hey, Terra gained a level. How about that? What do we got? We're heading here. We're gonna wrap up this freaking quest. You tried using GIMP? Why? Yeah, that's not a program anybody should use. And Terra! We're all here! It's the worst. Is Krita worse than GIMP? I think no. Not a big fan of Krita either. We gotta get that Esper. Maybe Terra can help restore some order to this town. We'll see. I haven't messed with that, well, at all. I mean, I guess I have in the fact that I messed with a Pi some, but... Well, that's pretty cool. Let's do a quick save state on here. I think it's F2, so I'll remember that. Really? Man, I should be playing some Hades, but I started this and said I'm going to play some Final Fantasy 3 again. I haven't done it for the stream, so... Anyway, let's... The first quest, yeah, or that first... section is super easy. It just Terra, Edgar, and Banan get him an arch, and that's it. This one is a little more annoying. This is the I hear you, man. I understand. I didn't really know if I wanted to stream tonight either, to be honest. So thanks for coaxing me into doing it. Crap. Okay. Can I... Did I buy 2 sprint shoes? I did not. Yeah, that's worthless. There's a typo I've never seen. My members. Hair lancet. It is. Sometimes it's pretty rewarding, but lately it just has been kind of like, eh. Okay. Damn, I really wish I bought a second sprint shoes. Yeah. Why not? Level 9. Okay. Steal merchant clothes. Does this connect? I think it does. No. Oh, I can steal that guy's clothes. I always do the Mario RPG, hit A to try and get a bonus whenever you do something in this game. Okay. He's nude, running off. Now I'm dressed like a merchant. Let's see here. I agree. I absolutely agree. Let's see, merchant, you may proceed. Okay, cool. Trying to find that hidden path. It's not here, it's somewhere else. Tonic. That's it, huh? Okay. What do we got up here. Oh, it's the rest of town. Let's see, so... I could steal the cadet uniform. Let's do that. Okay. I don't think I came up here. Yeah, I didn't. I started playing friggin' Dragon Warrior, Dragon Quest 1, the other day. And hey, welcome. I'm glad you're here. We're playing some old Final Fantasy 3 still. How are you doing? Now we've got two people in here. This is an active night. Do you want a Taco Bell update? You want to know what you missed? Oh, easy. I forgot. I gotta tell you. I've got a Yukito Kishiro book. That's a digital art book that I'm gonna send your way. My cool uncle found it. Taco Bell update. Let's repeat the old Taco Bell update. Taco Bell. I got two chicken enchilada burritos and a free fire reward of a cheesy bean and rice burrito, and this nearly finished Mountain Dew large. The price was nice at $9. Solid meal. It's usually the one that I default to. I will mix it up one of these days. Tell me about your Taco Bell. Talk about your eclipse. You went and actually experienced total natural darkness in the daytime. It sure does. I got some gripes about food and food costs. I want to talk some serious shit. So he won't let me through. Man. But you still have the option of your chili cheese burritos. They don't do it down here. It's horse shit. Will they just let me through? Oh, no, he won't. I want to talk about Uber Eats. Now, last weekend, the Battle Axe and I, old Daylena and me, have decided, you know, we should get some Firehouse. But I don't want to go anywhere. I don't want to be on 60. I don't want to drive anywhere. How much would it cost for me and Daylena to get Firehouse subs? The Axe, that's pretty good. How much would it cost to get two subs and a drink, one drink from Firehouse? And Uber Eats, after totaling it all up before tip, $50. 50 goddamn dollars. U.S. American. Now, we said, how much is it going to cost? Man, you'd just be stealing my food wrap. You're just doing it all. So we said, screw it, let's just go pick it up. And then we picked it up. And yeah. Yeah. I don't know. I was pretty upset because we, okay, I gotta pause this to talk about this. We didn't order anything extravagant. We were normal, regular size engineer and club sub. They had a special to where it was like, it was buy one, get one. But after the, you know, you buy one, get one, and then they put all the fees that basically is the other sub right on it. So you're paying for that shit. I have to. You've never been on this stream before where I'm holding up about this shit. I get mad as fuck about food. I think I talk more about food and food injustice. Where am I going? Hold on, Joe Martin. Remember this game here. Yeah, I've never, ever, ever raged about food or anything ever. I've never been irrationally upset. It's true. Can I sneak by you? Oh, okay. Yeah. That's what she had to do. Don't be switching me to just chatting. I'm talking serious shit here. Oh my god. I need to buy some of these freaking sprint shoes. Okay, reset in the Linux. I'll be here. I'm gonna wear these sprint shoes and now I'm gonna run farther. Let's see, so Locke's running around in uniform. Oh, I guess I'm out of luck. What am I doing? Okay, so that's how you get down here. I think I need the... Hold on. Somebody's texting me. It's probably the AX. We're discussing weekend plans. Alright, I guess I'm stealing this uniform now. Oh, couldn't steal! Ah, Locke. You great character. Dragon Warrior. That's what I was playing. I was playing the first freaking Dragon Warrior / Dragon Quest. And boy, is that game a freaking grind. I stole Guardian 1. Hold on. That can't be right. What the hell did I just steal? There's no way I stole what I think I just took. Is that what it really said? Oh, it's not that. I thought that was a better weapon than what that is. Is it? Damn, that's really good. Okay. I mean, really good for this part of the game, but... Yeah, as I'm fumbling around and like, what is this game? What do you do? What are words? Total hacks. Oh, receive soft. Ooh. Okay. So I'm not buying anything, that's true. I gotta deliver that old man his sire. Where is he? He's downstairs, right? I just played this game. I just played this game like 2 months ago. Why don't I remember how anything works? Ah! Okay. Okay, let me through. Where's your old man with cider? There he is. Ah, cool. It's the middle one, I think. Courage. Hell yeah. This part was changed in the remaster, too. Not this specific part, but what's coming up. So, they kept this. Our good friend Arg is not here. They are in Chicago at the C2E2. So they may or may not be here. Probably won't be, because I imagine they're tired. A traitor. How do you feel about Chicago hot dog? That's not a euphemism. I'm gonna save it. I'm gonna keep these clothes. These are fine. Yeah. I was told last time I was in Chicago, order a hot dog, Eat what they give you. Do not argue. And I didn't. And I watched what they put on there, and I was okay with most of it until they put a fucking cucumber on there. And then I was like, alright, what are we doing here? I think it was a cucumber. I picked that off. I was like, nope. This was the part that was changed. Was it a pickle? They don't have a punch in her. I thought they put a cucumber on there. No, I could eat a pickle on there. Something was gross. What the hell do they put on a Chicago hot dog? I know it ain't, man. Okay, hold up here. Toxic weight, green relish. I'm gonna argue with you. That's. Mm-mm. Yeah, raw onion's good. Tomato. Don't they put green peppers on it? That's what fucked me up. I was not a fan of that. I've had Portillo's since then, and I always get a dog, and then I'm like, they put all that other stuff. It is neon green. It's fine. It's natural. Sport peppers. Yeah, see, no. Can't do it. Can't do it. Portillo's is pretty solid. I usually do the chili dog, though. I'm sorry. I should have got Portillo's. Oh, it did. They released, I know the arcade game showed up on the Analog Pocket. Man, I didn't want to change. I was not a big fan of Celeste until the last playthrough. And man, Celeste is a much better character. Okay, that's cool. Has there been any update about him in that Neo Geo Pocket emulator? Because I'm surprised how few consoles can emulate it. Even the friggin' 3DS can't do it. All I want to do is play portable friggin' card fighters. Oh, Celeste. Oh, well. See, I didn't realize that, but that's interesting. I was talking about Celeste the character here. I have not played Celeste the platformer. I probably should. I've heard nothing but good stuff. I'm gonna take that key. Yeah. Some old card fighters. SNK versus Capcom card fighters. Big fan. I don't know why this line, this particular and some red too, mumble mumble. I love that. Kind of like Hearthstone, but better. Alright, let's save it. I think Celeste needs equipment. Yep. White cape's alright. I think I've heard that most of the... yeah, like Yu-Gi-Oh! The card game. Day used to play Yu-Gi-Oh! Had a whole bunch of cards and everything, and I thought that was just about the dorkiest thing I'd ever heard of. Cause I'm like, I didn't play that. Let's see. I like how this game gives me a new character and immediately just sidelines the other guy that I had. Yeah, I got no room. It's fine. Old they, them, they're alright. I'm gonna wind this clock. There's the lock. I ain't got no legs to stand on. Yeah, I believe that. Hey, what are you doing with your doom? Talk about that in the chat. Oh man, I'm about to get fucked up. What are you doing with your copies of Doom? Okay, hold on. Yeah, I turned my ads on. Dog food? Tacos. Oh, I hate this part. I'm sorry. Don't listen to this freaking... That's what I want, is get, like, sponsorship from Taco Bell. I think a lot of my life's problems would be redeemed if, like, I could just get free renewable Taco Bell. Welcome back! You can't be skipping lunch. Can't do it. I skip lunch. Can't do it. It's my they them. Can I get a Coke? You're the best. Listen, look at this. Yes, I want you to rant about Doom. Look how cool... Man. I don't deserve my cool wife, who's just at Publix and is gonna bring me something. For no reason. You gotta eat, steak lover! I do have some old, news. I will be vending at, a small con at, in Sarasota. They cut a deal with me for the vendor table, and May 11th I will be playing there. Really? You know, I think I remember that BFG edition for Doom 3. How did you feel about Doom 3? Do you care about it? I have a tent. Shit, I don't have any tents. I don't even know if I cared for it then. There's a few scenes that I remember really liking in it, like a few just moments. Like, I think there's one where, yeah, a tent. You got a tent, it heals you. Yeah, Doom 3 is really, like, that was the thing. Half-Life 2 came out at the same time, and you really felt that difference. Like, between the two, when they were like, what's going to be the better, more memorable game? And you had one that had, like, actual cinematic gameplay, and the other one was fucking Doom 3. Yeah. Old boner jokes. I don't know why I keep stealing, because it don't work. I'm not good at it, despite it being my character class. I'm sorry, everybody hates my ads, and I need them to be off. Okay. Now, I'm gonna disagree. I think a lot of mechanics that you see in Half-Life 2 have... really, really existed and survived the test of time, whereas Doom 3 has offered nothing new to the table. Thank you very much for the subscription. Oh my god, I got paid! Gonna get paid today! Not paid. I may not get paid. I don't think I've only been paid on the stream once, just because we got married. On the stream. But, oh. Ever. Oh, really? Okay. Well, please burn it. I appreciate it. Thank you. Thank you for your patronage. That's right. Some of it, if you got them, as they say. I knew what you were saying. Oh no, I've been stopped. Well, as one should. I'm really hoping to launch my other Twitch stream because I've been working on the layout and interface for it, and I really, really want to get it together soon. These fights, man! Just run. This is my first run fight. Holy shit! Don't die! It is. I mean, Ravenwood is entirely check out the engine game. It's like, check out the gravity gun. Check out that you can pick shit up. Like, it's all gimmicky. Like, it's like the 3D movie of games. There's a scene that I cannot help but the environment and setup of it. It is when, and I remember exactly when you play it and when I liked it. I have no idea why it stood out because I had a very sense of unease. It was going under the train, under the bridge where there were trains blocking it and you had to move the other train from above, but you had to climb under the bridge and under the rafters and stuff. And it was just like a really suspenseful, like it had a good audio design at the time. Like if I play it now, I'd be like, yeah, this sucks shit. But at the time, I remember just really, really isolated, and the idea of falling to your death really felt worse in that game to me. At that point, I don't know, but okay, let's save it because I'm gonna have a boss fight. But yeah, overall story and stuff, it's really clunky. I mean, the fact that the episodes are never going to complete. I hear you. I don't think a Half-Life 3 could come out and have that same kind of appeal. Tunnel armor! Okay, so now it teaches me runic. So he'll cast something, I hope. It's a neat ability, but it doesn't do anything. Gives me MP. No, I agree. Alright, yes, I agree. Like, it's not good. It's not as good as it was. It doesn't hold up. But, it's totally better than Doom 3. Old man rants. I never even played any of the, like, I'm sure there were, like, expansion episodes and stuff for Doom 3. I just never even played that. I'm gonna say, though, I've played Half-Life 2, numerous times. I played Doom 3 once. And I think when you get the Soul Cube, it just goes downhill. Like, it's like, the difficulty's not there. Oh, man. Gotta play Doom. Oh, shit. I'm letting everybody die. Oh, my God, I'm gonna die. Fucked up. You fucker. Okay. No, no, no! Just total commitment. Just fucking kill him. I kinda need her for this. I hate that Phoenix Downs only pick you up at, like, nothing and then you get zapped. I'm dead. This fucking guy. Let's reload. Got smoked by tunnel armor. That's okay. I got beat by freaking ultras too, by being dumb. Tunnel armor. It won't hurt us, except when it fucking murdered me last time. Well, that's good. It's good waste. I love Phantasy Star 2. I love all of them. The first one less, the least, but mostly 2. I love 2, I love 4. 3's alright, and 1 is just okay. But I would love to play Phantasy Star 2 and have a reason to play it. What I really want to play, if I was going to play another different RPG right now, it would be Lunar. It would probably be Eternal Blue. I've been in a mood for that. I've played 2. 2 is, 2 is one of the games that made me want to draw. Oh, yeah, it is, but it isn't. Like, for the time. This is, again, for the time, I think it was fine. Gotta do your RPG streams. It's a good, you know, I can talk through it, you know. I'm fucked. I'm fucking dead again. It is. Boy, I do not like the JRPG era of having to perpetually grind. Fucker! Oh my god. I hate this boss. And I'm dead. Kernihilated. Ugh. What level am I? I'm level 10. Do I have to grind a few more levels? I really don't want to. I wish you could bait him into more magic attacks. Well, I might be getting pissed off. We might be playing some Phantasy Star 2. Tunnel armor! I can just simply draw the attack with my runic blade, and then we'll die when I get hit with a fucking drill. What if I steal from him? What do I get? Well, the grind used to be more fun when you were a kid and had, like, no responsibilities. But now I don't want to do it. That's, again, Pixel Remaster, you level up 3 times faster. You could, you can turn off the random encounters. I got another Air Lancet. Oh, okay, cool. If I can watch this, I'll be fine. If I keep runicking with her, I think then I can do it. So I keep switching it. If I die again, which looks like it's going to happen.
Yo, Joe!
I may actually do that. I think I might. After this quest, because I'm almost done with it. Holy shit! Oh no! I wish I could freaking limit break my attack, but I know I can't. The chances of it happening are real low. Oh, you dirty dog. Fucking 6 HP. Oh. Thank God. Okay. heal both of us. Come on. Fucking one HP. Oh, good. That was about worthless. Oh, fuck you. Oh. I hate this goddamn boss. Because as much as they give you the illusion of tactics with this... Oh, well, go ahead. Do that again. Maybe I can kill him. Nope. Maybe I can kill him. Maybe I can kill him. Do it quick. Get the fuck out. Fine. I'll take it. A win's a win's a win. Okay. I'm not suplexing it. That's coming up. That's coming up literally right now. The long scenario. A cookie is just a cookie, but Newton's is fruit and cake. I'm an old ass man. I remember that shit. It is. This is the time for suplex. The part of the game that everyone remembers. Now I have to. If I get through this, because I typically stream for 2 hours, which I probably will. Okay, so here's Saban. He beat Ultros, and he's flowing down the river. Oh no, I'm done flowing down the river. Just know that I may take off at any time if I feel like it. You do. Welcome, my partner. Oh, shit, you know what? I still don't have any... Shadows music is great. There it goes. Oh. I'm an old man. He's an old man. See the goods! Yeah, I'm here. Gotta buy these sprint shoes. Gotta buy some old tents. Gotta all pitch a tent. How many of these do I have? Only 3 left? 5? Yeah, buy a bunch of them. Plumed hat is an upgrade for both my dudes. Shuriken. I never use these things, and I want to. They're cool. I'll equip them anyway. I'll buy some friggin' ninja stars. I never use Shadow's friggin' throw ability. But I should, because it's cool. He does not have a shield. Okay. Let's save it. Where are we going? We're going this way. Can I suplex? I think I can. Oh, dog's gonna kill you. I can. Suplex that rabbit. Boom! Easy peasy. Okay, come on. I'm gonna throw some old ninja stars. No reason, just want to. Just pretty good. It's pretty good too. Easy, who's your ideal party in this game? Because mine is pretty much Terra, Edgar, Sabin, and Shadow? Once I get there with them. Well, time for trouble. Really? Oh, man. God, I played the hell out of this game. Like this era of Final Fantasies, you get a ton of characters. Cyan's great, but there's a lot of just... You won't ever use them characters. I think Setzer is, unfortunately, he's a cool character, but I don't ever use him. Strago. I'm playing on RetroArch. I'm using Messin right now. Messin S. And, yeah. Just old, the SN30 Pro Retrobit controller. And my laptop. Steal them games! That's the catchphrase of Thursday Night Retro Game Night. Steal them games! I do have an official Final Fantasy III. It's over there. I'm not gonna get it right now. You did. It was really awesome. Look at these clowns. Here he comes. I have the I have it boxed with the Final Fantasy VI, and I've got Final Fantasy III in the U.S. and they're both boxed. Please clip me, steal them games, steal them, steal all the games, all them retro games. Cyan, it's there. Oh, the soundtrack in this game is amazing. I only have three? It randomizes. Sometimes you have three, sometimes you have four. The sword text, they change them too in remaster. Not that anybody cares, but in remaster you have access to all the basic sword text. You can just select them rather than wait. You have not. Guess who's home? I hear my lovely wife. My sweet, lovely baby wife. And our son, Nanook, he's running in. He's terrified by the sound of a bag. Mwah. Hi, look who it is.
Missed you.
Oh, I missed you. Mm-hmm. And here I am playing a damn shitty game that I've played before. You're gonna eat your food? Okay. Everyone says hello. Okay. Nanook will be in later. Yeah, he's the real star of the show. Do not talk to that dog. I can ask. Goodnight wants to know if you got his pub sub. They shut it down early? Really? Oh, damn. Yeah, they ran out of bread. They're shitty Publix. They are. I'm sorry, they let us both down. Yeah, Publixes have been migrating. They have been as far up as, I know North Carolina has them. Yeah, I can hear you that. I would get Portillo's. We've been talking about so much food. I think that's all I do anymore is talk about food on this thing. I fucked up that blitz. I didn't realize Publix was as far up as Virginia. I've got a Publix contact. I need to find out how far George Jenkins' evil empire goes. I mean, I'll try to get one in Madison. They don't listen to me, but I'll see what I can do. Okay, more plot. Oh, General Leo. I need to look and find. There has to be General Leo hacks because his character's awesome. Fuck? What happened? Oh. General Leo's awesome. He's the good guy on the bad guy team. Daylena, what are you watching? Okay. That's a good idea. Good night. I know you've watched Fallout. Sweater Alliance, have you watched Fallout yet? Because it's totally worth it. It's on the right side near the top. Oh no, Nanook's gonna get his ass beat. He's being a baddie. I'm glad that Fallout was as good as it was. I was worried about it, but I'm glad that it lived up. You know, exceeded expectations. I probably honestly would have played Fallout 1 on here for Retro Night. But no, instead we're doing this. Story on rails right now. Kefka's gonna poison that river. Gonna suplex him. Boing. Whap. Oh, what was it? Wait, he says. Do I look like a waiter? And then we chase him down all over the place. I think I need to go in here, though. It won't play. Why won't it? Can you turn off and turn the Roku back on? I wonder, I think I can fight this robot. No, I can't. This is a monster in the box. Use some of these millions of taunts I bought. That about Linux? It's like a number, like color display kind of thing, or what? It's not gonna work. Always be suplexing. Welcome back. I don't blame yourself. Do you know the history of the translation, the US translation of this game? The Ted Woolsey story about how he had like three weeks to translate this game that was given to him and with a rush order. And that's why certain lines in this are so essentially terrible. The translation is not perfect to what the Japanese one was at all. It was good enough for me. I remember the weird thing. When this game came out, Nintendo criticized the story as slow and boring and not for Western audiences. And I was like, I don't know about that. But it's pretty true. You are lucky that you got what you got. I look at certain games. Case in point, talking about Lunar, the voice talent in an era where voice talent was terrible. Okay, all right. We'll disagree there, but that might also be rose-colored glasses. It is. It is a slow build to get where it needs to go, but when it does get there, it's pretty cool. Now it'll let me run. I do think these splitting into three parties to get the start of this game does work against it. What'd you think? Okay, hard disagree. Fallout 2 is amazing. It's not a watch game, it's a play game. You should play it, and I think the options and stuff open to you in Fallout 1 and 2 are incredible. I feel like it's more developed than 3, even though 3 has quite a bit to do and it is fun. The options and flexibility of Fallout 1 and 2, it's easily one of the best RPGs ever made. Hands down. It does look miserable. You don't even really need to grind in Fallout 1. You can beat the game real low level if you want. You can. Oh. Dead family. Dead family update. Yeah, this is, I mean, definitely on rails. Yeah, I don't like the, like, when we're talking about bad intros to games, I don't like the intro to one, Fallout 1 or Fallout 2. Because of the Temple of Trials in 2 is really grueling and tough. I'm shocked Nintendo kept a dead family in Final Fantasy 3. Just randomly looking at this. It would have made them like, oh, they went to sleep, but they couldn't wake up. They were cursed. No, they just flat out. They're totally dead. Yeah. And here's the thing, man. I played Fallout 1 and 2 quite a bit. Like, when I had them, I did play them for a year. Voice talent in Fallout 1 and 2 as well, especially for a game of that era. You had, like, you know, not A-list celebrities, but you did have Hollywood celebrities and people doing voice acting in that game. So it's pretty surprising for Interplay, especially in 97. Yeah. Fallout's openness is also, you can walk around anywhere and do things, and then it's like, oh, guess what? Here's Deathclaws. Nope, you shouldn't have been there. So, it does sort of rail off certain areas. Yeah, it's kind of like Mass Effect. Mass Effect took me a very long time to actually get hooked by the story. That's a game you want to talk about being slow and boring in the beginning. I was like, oh, it's Star Wars, because it's like, oh, no human being's ever been a Spectre before. I'm like, boy, I wonder what my human being's going to do. He's going to be a Jedi Knight. And then the game is on rails until it's not, and then it told a pretty cool story, but it took quite a bit of time to get there. I've been wanting to go back and play at least ME 1 and 2. I don't know if I can still deal with 3. 3 was good until it really wasn't, and unfortunately it really wasn't at the dead last of the game. Okay. I will admit that Fallout 1 and 2, particularly 3, the guide is necessary to find stuff, to do any of the side quests and all the other stuff that, you know, makes that game fun, because wandering around aimlessly can, but it's miserable. Like, the first time I beat 2, there was stuff I didn't realize you could do until much later. And now I really, really want to play Fallout. At least 1 or 2. I don't know which one yet. Probably 2. Yeah. kind of like Simon's Quest. It's very much like, oh, it's so esoteric. Like, how would you know to crouch here? And hold it, you know, until... Yeah. Agreed. Nothing but poison this way. It is, yeah. It's like the game doesn't tell you what to do. End of the line. Time to fight. These are still cool mech designs. They're so neat. I think they're just totally separate animal games, though. Like, I think better is subjective. I think that I enjoy both. Like, I enjoy a narrative that's trapped on rails because you can do great story elements that you don't have with an open world game. But then Fallout is my exception to that because you can do a very open world game and give you high key points that make your nameless, faceless, you know, daring do character, you know, have weight, like have character weight. So. A lot of this game right here is, like nostalgia. I can 100% guarantee, like, there's stuff in this that I can't expect a 13-year-old to pop in and want to play this game based on how it looks, how it plays, and how it feels. It's for old people who remember this game being good. Oblivion, Skyrim. You know, those are okay, but again, fantasy's not my thing, like, really, normally, as I play Final Fantasy. Let's use a tent. Enjoy your dinner. Thanks for popping in. What are you eating? Save it. Daggerfall, yeah. That was like the one before Merlin. What kind of pizza? You can't just leave on that. You gotta tell us. Yeah, everybody loved Daggerfall. I remember Daggerfall being hyped up when I was in high school. My friend was talking about it. It's like Doom, but like way open world and everything's in real distances. And I was like, oh, that sounds amazing. And then I never played it. And then later in life, when I tried to play it, I was like, eh, I can't. Okay, is this... Oh, that's Delma. I will give the credit to every... That doesn't sound too bad at all. Go enjoy it. I'll stop holding you up. Go eat your pizza. Like I was saying, everybody's unique ability giving you either do a button mash or a button command or another menu or something. It makes it feel like you're not just clicking A. So I give the game credit for this too. Let's go and do this. Actually, let's save it real quick. I'll do a proper save. I realize I haven't. And you're gonna miss out on the best part. I forgot I didn't have the freaking sprint shoes. I thought I did have the sprint shoes. Why are they off? Why did it unequip everything? That is super insane.
Okay. I didn't set it to do that. I don't think I did. I'm gonna equip him all this crap and then he's gonna take off. I know it. He's gonna freaking leave, like, before I'm done with the train. Because him leaving is random. I think it's depending on the number of fights you're in. Recovery spring. Still super cool spray work in this game. Always loved when Squaresoft did those really cool, like, bodies of water and clouds and stuff. Always thought it was super cool. I gotta get through this, then I gotta get through freaking getting Gao in my party, then getting the helmet, then going underwater. Ugh. That'll definitely round out the stream for tonight. No, I never did. I got to the last area, and I think I gave up, because I just got really pissed at it. I guess there's value in having a game that you get that upset with, but shit, did that game piss me off. I'm trying to think of the last damn boss I beat in it. Like, it's rewarding when you do, but every time I've tried to play it, it's been with two people, which means the boss is hard. It becomes harder because you have two people. So definitely not the way to play that, but maybe I'll go back. Let's get on board this old phantom train. It's time. This is a fun part. Knock it off. Oh, it's Street Trash. It's a movie about hobos. It's literally about homeless people who are affected by their own little homeless junkyard turf war, and also a bottle of old hooch that is poisonous toxins that make them melt. This guy's on the toilet when he drinks it, and he starts bubbling up and getting gross. It's worth the watch. It's pretty fun. The old still goings. Love those random dog attacks from Interceptor. Street Trash is great because it's got a segment that involves a man pulling another man's dick off and playing keep away throw around with the penis for about 3-4 minutes. It's a full comedic segment, and it is ridiculous. I think a dog eats it. I think is what happens. I don't remember, like, all of it, but it's pretty wild. Made by a New York film professor in 1986. It's pretty wild. Pretty wild stuff. Definitely worth the watch. Do I have to go all the way back? Now I gotta get in 10 more fights. I wish Saban had his hit everybody attacks, but I don't. I don't think I do. I'll find out in a second, because if I do, I'll do that. I think I learned that much later. Yet. There it is. beat up that ghost. I want to get one to join me. Oh, you can't go forward, that's right. I don't want to waste my ghost here. Many, 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 many ghosts on this train. Yeah, he's a helpful ghost. This is so cool. The setup and scripting of this part, I've always felt it was really, really super clever and fun. Like my other ghost buddy is shocked. Kills him. Who won't? Some guys you can. Okay. Dining car. Let's eat. Time for a ghost dinner. Really? I wish the freaking, yeah, they're neat. I've seen enough of Amano's art where I'm like, that's really cool. I really like his magic card, or their magic cards. But those are also stupid expensive, and I can just look at the high-res art and I'm like, yeah, that's cool. I appreciate it, but I've never been, like, super mega big on it. As much as I like Final Fantasy and how it is the game. I don't know. No fun. Did order at the table. Yeah, it's limited to the games that it's associated with, I think. For sure. This bomb before it kills me. Yeah. I think it's a controversial take, but a take that makes sense. Okay. I think Siegfried takes this if I try and get it. Shadow. Save the day. Random counter doubly worked. I don't get whatever's in there. That's fine. Nope. Okay. Keeping this ghost, he sucks. I mean, he's another attack shield, basically, but that would be why. Oh my god. I don't remember this game being so fighty. And I know it's supposed to, but god lord. I mean, it breaks it up. It's not the worst, but yeah, it kind of is the worst. Phoenix down, sniper sight, Phoenix down, and the monster in the box. Pretty much. Oh, my ghost buddy's gonna leave. I do not. I know about one that, like, involves, like, some steps. I think it's, like, a secret percentage or something. Like the height isn't right or something. It doesn't align right. Okay, so how do I do this? I want to say it was this one. This one. Oh yeah. The pain elemental one. That's I think another one you're talking about. Yeah, that's what it was. It was something about that. I remember Carl Jobs was talking about it. Huh. This was by design or accident? Here you go. Get ready. That guy's a machine. Here it is. Yeah. And while is that is fun. Do this instead. Yeah. And I got my tent back. That's sweet. Oh, come on, game. Phoenix down kills it one hit. It's undead. Yep. Always check the types. Yep, that's the thing. People always assume the suplex is what kills it. Suplex is funny and fun to do, but it's technically undead, so you throw a phoenix down on it and it will die. Saves you a little bit of time. That's it. Just leave? No. It'll eventually let me. Okay. And there it is. Okay. Save. Almost done with this part. We're at 8:35. This is where I jump in the falls. I'm gonna have to do the last thing. I'll have to use these while I can. So I think I'm at the end of him. Oh, I'm pissed off. I'm pissed off again. I think Berserk's pretty good. It just doesn't let me choose to not attack, but I think my attacks even do more damage. There comes... Aww. Save it, because I know I got a fight that sucks. Just ready to jump down the falls. Shadow will leave, I think. Yep. Why not? Jump. Hopefully I'm leveled to beat this thing. I think if I sword attack an aura bolt all the way down, should be fine. Realize the length of this game. This is going to be like a 20 million part series. I may take some intermittent breaks though, so I can play other games. Save file won't go anywhere. Easy enough boss. A lot easier than the last time I fought him. Yay, a remedy and a tonic and no XP. You want to talk characters that are useless? This is probably one of my least favorites. I don't like Gao. I don't think his abilities are worth it. You have to spend too much time Pokemon farming him. I probably just haven't looked into his abilities very much to know, like, what's the best ones. To get him so I can finish this last part. I'm just running. I don't want to deal with any of this right now. Will I run? Come on. No, I'll die. Okay. NASA, I think. That's Mobley's. The mass is further south. I think it's on the Imperial continent. I don't do this because I don't have any food for you. Get out of here. There's my bliss. Yep, it's right there. Okay. Take the elixir. Might want to check on this. I think this is... Would you like to sell all of your Phoenix towns? Yes. Yes, I would. Okay, so I sent hit. Let's see. 8:45. Can I finish this last part? I hope so. Please show up. Of course not. It's okay, I need to come down here anyway. Oh god. Mandatory dialogue. On already. Okay. Couldn't have been shortened at all. Thanks, I'll unequip him as soon as I possibly can. Ugh. Was that like 6 minutes? Just dialogue? Come on, game. This ain't no Kojima game. Can't be doing that. Okay. Have to come back here with a mug. Okay. Is there something over here? No. Oh, there's a something. As I lose money. I do. almost done. Gameplay hours. Okay. Mode 7 graphics. One helmet for three people. That's okay, game. We get it. I do like the aquatic river travel theme because it doesn't appear anywhere else. That's a cool setting, too. So I do get these. Let's use magic tech armor. Matsu really did his homework for this freaking game. I tell you, the soundtrack's amazing. Probably should heal Cyan. Since he's only got 46 hit points and is now probably dead. Yep. Well, at least I realized it. At least there's no bosses. I think one of the cats is one of his best things, from what I remember reading. Seven 16. Alright, 5 minutes left on the stream. Let's get to the end of it. Spinning in circles. Let's take you to the cave. No! Did it mess up? Cave, right? There it is. Breaking the wall where I can get in there. Should be near the end. That's it. deal with this town. There's nothing here. Save it. Hop aboard. Let's get to our next save point. And the three intro quests are complete. And I will hold off on the decisive battle until next stream, but I'll finish this dialogue here. Totally worth it. The screen ratio is off on this because everybody's pixels are all blown out. Oh well. Can't win them all. Here comes everybody. Japan, you and your storytelling. Alright, so here we are. I'm gonna go ahead and save it. And I'm gonna go ahead and backup save it right here. And that will conclude tonight's Thursday night retro game night programming. This is part two of the Final Fantasy III. Spread 3 hours 19 minutes. I mean, it's not bad. Got pretty far. And, yeah, I think I'm going to go spend some time with my wife, wrap this up. It is the 9 o'clock hour. So I will be here next Thursday, 7 p.m., doing this or something else again. Maybe we'll play that Phantasy Star 2. Maybe I'll play something else. Maybe I'll play Rocket Knight Adventures. Maybe I'll play Bucky O'Hare. Maybe I'll play any of the various games in Santa Sack, but we will see. As I always say, the new patented catchphrase, steal them games when it comes to retro games. Thursday night retro game night. Happy to have you here. Great talk. Great chat.
great game, and have a good night. Let me go ahead and sign it off here.